Hi, if you're planning to add the approval process to your Zoho CRM, but you don't know how it works and how to implement that, this video is for you. I'm going to show you here how to add the approval process to the Zoho CRM. Let's say you're getting your Zoho CRM, go to the top right here to the setup. Inside of the setup, you have approval process. To explain the overall context here, is basically you're going to create a process to approve one of the records in the CRM. For now, we're going to use the leads, but it can be replicated to all the other modules here, okay? Let's start here, click Add Approval Process. We are going to choose, as I mentioned, for now, the module leads, but you could choose any other module. Let's add here, Leads Approval Process, the name. You can add any description. You can choose, it can be based on the record creation or on both, or just when the record is added. Let's do for record creation. Let's say you have a company that you receive a lot of leads, or your sales team is adding leads nonstop, and you want to make sure like you receive, you only add the leads that are worth adding. Like you pretty much do a little approval in the process. So the leads that you have are pre-qualified. Let's choose add rule to this process. The criteria can be based on like if annual revenue of the company, let's say it can be based on the city. You can choose how you want to base your criteria here. You can go, let's for this case, so it's gonna be for every single lead. Let's go and add, last name is a mandatory for our lead. Let's put last name is not empty. It means any lead that comes in, if it has a last name, and in our case, they're mandatory, every lead will have the last name, we'll go through the process. Who should approve? You can add more criteria here. As you can see, it can be and or based however you think you should go and approve the lead. Let's take this out. Let's use like every single lead for now. Who should approve? You can choose a user, a role, group, levels, manager, or record owner. In this case, we're going to use a user. Let's choose Alex Vaz. Demo is the one that I'm using right now. You can assign a task. If you had any task specific, you could go and assign here. It means for the record, it will assign a task for Alex Vaz demo when it moves for the approval. You can go and click here. As usual, you would create a task that would be related to this one. Let's cancel. So right now we are not adding a task. We're gonna go and update a field. In this lead, I added the approved date, and it's gonna be the date at the execution date. Pretty much what it happens whenever the lead's approved, it go and we'll put a date for the approved date. That's done. As you can also add tasks for the record owner, send emails. We are going to skip those for now, call some functions, use a web hooks. But let's go for the rejection. In the rejection, we go update a field as well. We have the reject date, the same way we put the execution date, done. And we add an email to send to the record owner. You can send an email to the requester, manager, everyone approved, and both of them. But in this case, we're gonna send to the requester. We select a template, we have the reject lead. It has the information. If we click here, you see I use like the link, use the meta tag to add the ID, to add the name, so the person receives a customized email. Let's click associate. Now we have, in this case here, created. It's a basically any lead that comes in, because we put last name is not empty and last name is a mandatory. The person approving is Alex Fias demo, which is the user right now. And approval, it will update the field approved date. In rejection, it would update the field rejected date, and it will send an email to the person who requests. Let's click done and save. Now let's go and create a lead. Lead create. Let's put Alex, Vice lead just for tests. Let's put one. Email, we can put Vice at testing.com. Company, let's keep the other Cornerstone Solutions. And let's click save. As you see, when it saves, it puts this little icon here. That means the lead is locked. If someone, but not me, because I'm the approval, come over here, try to edit. You see, it's not possible to edit this lead. It's up there. And right now, I could have received an email or a task saying that I have a lead for me. And I have the options to approve, reject, or delegate. Let's click approve. Let's put a comment, testing, approve. Now the lead has been approved. You can see now you can edit, make changes, and an email. If we click here, you see the workflow has been processed, sent an email for approval. And also you saw here, the approved date was added through the process. It was updated with the day of today. The same way, if we go back, we have a second one. Let's use this one here. We clone. Actually, let's don't clone. Let's go and create a new one. So we have a fresh one. Alex, task two. Email Alex two at testing.com. Solutions, and let's click save. Again, it has been locked, waiting for a response. You come over here and reject. You would give an explanation if you want and click reject. Right now you see the reject date was changed to May 14th. The person, my email was sent through the workflow to let the person know that the approval process, so the person knows that the record has been rejected. The person would like, you could add explanation, what to do, and you would go and make the change and send back for resubmit here for approval. That's the overall process. As I mentioned, it can go further here in the way that you build. You can use for different modules. And it can be very helpful to keep your CRM clean. If you have any question about the approval process or anything else related to Zoho, please contact us. We would be eager to help you.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.